Hi, I'm in one of our outbuildings today and I'm going to be doing some pointing, and I thought I'd just show you some of the techniques that I use to get a good pointed joint. Now, these walls are 300 years old and they are stone, and they're laid onto a mortar which is just clay. And what's happened over the years, some of the clay's come out because it goes friable, and I'm going to be replacing it with a lime based mortar. And I'm using a hydraulic lime, because that way the wall will breathe, and it also, the mortar itself is quite elastic, so it will give a little bit. Cement kills these walls. They do not breathe, they don't let any moisture through, and effectively they start to crack very early on. So that's what I'm going to be doing. Now, I've made myself a little tool to clear out the old joints and to get rid of the loose clay, and it's just a little bit of steel bar with a wooden handle. And all I've done is I've just cleaned out, rake back any loose clay, then I'm going to brush it, and then I'll wet it after I've mixed up the mortar prior to putting the mortar into the joints. So after raking out, I'm just going to brush out the loose dust from the joints where I'm going to be working, then I'll mix up the mortar, and then I'll just wet these joints prior to putting the mortar in. The mixture for the mortar is 4 parts sharp sand to 1 part of the hydraulic lime. And this is hydraulic lime and it's NHL 3.5, so it's an averagely hard lime, and it's ideal. It dries fairly rapidly. I don't use aerated lime because it does take a long time to dry, but it's also very, very aggressive to the skin, and so discretion being a better part of valour, I'd rather use what I consider to be the safer and more rapidly drying hydraulic lime. So I'm dry mixing it to get an even texture and even colour. Then I'll add water. Now, this is going to be a fairly dry mix. The reason I don't want it too wet is that the mortar will not stain the stonework if it goes onto the front face of the stone. Also, overworking a very wet mix of lime mortar tends to bring the lime to the front face, and it weakens the mortar further down in the joint. So a drier mix is the better mix to handle. The other thing you can see while I'm doing this is I am wearing gloves when I'm handling this material. I'm going to change to a more robust waterproof glove when I actually start handling it, because it does really, really aggressively attack the skin if you use it too much. So always protect your skin when handling these mortars. I might just take a little sample, see what it's like. Not quite. I'm just going to put a little bit more water in, but not a lot. It's very close to the consistency I want. That's nice. Sticking to the trowel quite nicely, and I should be able to pick it up and it will stick to the small pointing trowel, and that will be to the width of the joint that I want. Good, so all I do now is wet the wall down in the area I'm going to work. If you've got a sprayer, water sprayer, that's great. I've got something a little bit more fundamental and basic, just a wet brush. I've known people drink a glass of water and then spray it out via the mouth. So any trick will do. And then I'm ready to put the mortar into the raked out joints. Here I've raked it back to about 1 inch, about 20-25 millimetres deep. In other areas it's deeper. If it's big and deep, such as here, I'll put a few stones in as well, small stones, because behind this face there's rubble and clay, so we want to add something to that. But the exterior face of the wall, outside and inside the building, are sound, so it's just that the inner bits collapsed a bit, but it's still solid. Okay, now I'm going to change my gloves to waterproof ones. I must take care of the hands, and we can start pointing. So let's just take a small bit and be going to the joint. And the whole point about a mortar is it's not to really bond the stones together, it's actually to hold the stones apart. So what happens is that if you start to lose that mortar, then the stones or the bricks can collapse and tumble, and that makes the wall unstable. So what I want is a mortar that's going to be rigid enough to give the supportive weight, but I don't want it too stiff that it's going to resist the elastic movement that the wall has. And in these old walls, they do have a flexible bit of movement, and the cement wall will not cope with that as easily as a natural wall like this. Now, while I've gone over these, what I'm going to do, I'll clean that off with a wire brush afterwards, and there'll be no remnants at all of the lime left on that when I've done. So I'm going to pack this hole here, which is quite deep, get plenty of mortar in. It can be painstakingly slow, but it's better than having to build the whole front to the building, and it will last probably another 300 years. Which ain't bad. Get a stone in there. And that's it. Just keep working away, nice and steadily. Probably take 300 years to do this, but the bad news is this ain't the part of wall I'm worried about. Come to do a joint like this, it's quite deep. That's the thickness I want to go to, about a centimetre. So I make my piece of mortar about a centimetre thick, and then work out which way I'm going to put the mortar in. I'm going to go in like that, so I want to put it on this edge. So I'm just going to cut a piece of mortar, scrape it up the trowel, and then it can go into the joint. Once again, put the mortar on the trowel into the joint, and it can go quite deeply like that, no problem at all. That's it done. Now I'm not going to go all the way along these, because when I started to rake them out, there was actually pieces of stone that are touching here, and there's no real need for it there. So all I'm doing is the essential parts, which are going to stabilise the wall. Up on the ladder, it's a lot deeper. The fissures are really quite worn out, and there's a lot of clay has come out. So I am going to be doing essentially nearly every joint is going to need to be done.
And just in case you think I just hold the camera, this is my bit of pointing and stonework from, oh, I think it's about 3 years old now. It's when we put this recycled glass window into the front of the house, and we had to make up the difference between the woodwork and the stone. And the really great thing about working on old buildings is that you've got so much interesting history that they show within the walls. This longhouse was a post house in the 19th century. And you can see that the fireplace actually begins quite high up, the level of the fireplace, and also the door begins really high up. And that is because this was the cellar. It was a walk-in cellar, I presume, where they kept all the food for the inn. And next door, there is a massive fireplace. And in here, they could have roasted a couple of pigs by the look of it. And they'd probably have been ready for them as well when they traveled by carriage all the way from the south. You can still see these wonderful blackened beams, which I presume was the smoke coming out from the fire here. Absolutely fantastic. And here's the outside of the building that Andy's working on. As he says, it's about 300 years old, possibly a little older, because the chickens actually scratched up a couple of coins a couple of years back, and they are money that feudal money, and they are dated 1630 and 1615. So it's a house with a great history. Well, worth preserving.
Thanks for watching!